has some room. In there for the touchdown. Coming home here in lane five. Well out in front of the field. And Lachek touches in a time of 52.92, a new high school national record. Back to back to back to back state champions. NET Sports is your home for championship sports, and we are live from the Bob Devaney Sports Center in Lincoln, Nebraska. As we conclude our day with a Class A showdown for a state title, it's the seventh seed Titans of Papillion-La Vista South taking on number four seed Gretna. And good evening, everyone. I'm Larry Putney, along with Kathy Wieskamp. It's great to have you with us for one final time here this evening as we get set to crown a champion Class A. Let's start with Gretna. They've never won a state title. Opportunity for a first.
Never won a state title. Excited to be here. And again, they've really kind of grown. They've moved into the Class A ranks. And really, this Metro tournament, their conference tournament, is really when they started saying, we have a potential. Played really well there and have played well through the state tournament.
Papillion-La Vista South comes in with a bevy of talent, of tradition. They've put it together here late in the year. You'd think a team with 17 losses right. might not be here, but they've put it together late.
Really, they've kind of gone through ebb and flow, ups and down through the season, but really are peaking right now, feel very cohesive. They're doing some really good things as a team, and they're really playing for each other and as a team, and that's put them into the state championship. First-year coach, really excited to be here.
It is the Class A showdown to the championship. Gretna and Papillion, obviously both right in the metro area. They know each other well. How do they get here to the state championship? Here's a look at the bracket. Gretna knocked off Millard West in the first round, and then Millard North, the defending state champ, 3-2. That was a good one. Papillion-La Vista South with two sweeps over Elkhorn South and Pius the 10th. Ryan Mix is the third member of our crew. He has been patrolling the sidelines, not in a creepy way, but just patrolling the sidelines all day. Let's send it back to him.
Well, thank you, Larry. I try not to patrol the sidelines in a creepy way. We're really looking forward to this match here. The Class A match, the 7 seed Papio South and Gretna, the 4 seed. For Gretna, it's just their second year competing in Class A, so they've had a really difficult challenge with their schedule this year. And they did face Papio South earlier in the year, a match. Papio South won 2-1, but that was in mid-September. So it's been a while since these teams have faced. And Gretna has been playing their best volleyball at the right time. They've won 9 out of their last 10 matches. Some wins in there include defeating Millard West twice, Omaha Marion, Elkhorn South, and Millard North. Head coach Mike Brandon said they are not scared of this moment. Should be another great match to cap off the state championships.
Thank you very much, Ryan. We're ready for our final match of the day. It's in Class A. The Dragons, the Titans, someone will take over the trophy before the night's done. Come on back.
The morning doesn't always start when you want it to. It starts when it has to. And day or night, we're up when you are. Through the good times, through the tough times. For the necessary and the unexpected. Even when you don't need us at all, we're just a light switch away. And when it's finally time to call it a night, we keep the lights on, ready to do it all over again. Nebraska Public Power District. Powering your every day, every day.
Early mornings, late nights, emotionally, physically, mentally tougher. Generations of trust, innovation, and hard work done side by side. The decisions you make for your land and livestock have a direct impact on your operation, the region, and the world. That is why we're there when you need us anytime, every time. We both have one chance, one season, one mission. Tougher together. Aurora and you.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
What do you think about going to college?
I'm kind of scared.
I feel nervous a little bit.
That's kind of a tough one. I'm not really sure yet.
I'm excited for college.
How are you going to pay for it?
To be honest, I don't really know.
That's actually a really good question.
So what if you had a friend you could ask?
Have you ever wondered what happens to soybeans after they're harvested? Every year, soybean farmers invest a portion of their soybean revenue to fund research, marketing, and promotion which is called the Nebraska Soybean Checkoff. 80% of the harvested soybeans are crushed into soybean meal that's used to feed poultry and livestock. The other 20% is made into soybean oil that's used for cooking oil and biodiesel. To learn more about the Nebraska Soybean Checkoff, NebraskaSoybeans.org.
We are back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. Student section's ready to go. The fans are packed in here. They're ready to go. We're ready to go for one final time. Class A state title on the line between Gretna and Papillion-La Vista South. And now for introductions, let's go to Steve Lemon.
Gentlemen, welcome to the Bob Devaney Sports Center and the 2019 Nebraska School Activities Association State Volleyball Championships. Today's championship match in Class A features the number 7 seeded Papillion-La Vista South Titans and the number 4 seed Gretna Dragons. The NSAA is proud to recognize our premier corporate partners for their outstanding support of NSAA activities. U.S. Bank, Farmers Mutual of Nebraska, the Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association, Nebraska Orthopedic and Sports Medicine, and CHI Health St. Elizabeth. And now it's time for the introduction of the players and coaches. Here are the Papillion-La Vista South Titans. Number 1, Ashlyn Dirks. Number 2, Delaney Valinch. Number 3, Brecken Moore. Number 4, Aaliyah Clark. Number 5, Harley Cole. Number 6, Dayton Valinch. Number 7, Stella Adeyemi. Number 8, Angelia Petrovic. Number 9, Kinley Siss. Number 10, Emma O'Neill. Number 11, Ava LeGrand. Number 12, Margaret Madden. Number 13, Sophie Hendricks. And number 14, Shaylee Weavers. The assistant coaches are Cassie Young, Justine Lang, Erin Warren, Kelly Solomon, and Jamie Burr. The head coach in her first season is Katie Wright. And now here are the Gretna Dragons. Number 2, Hannah Cathell. Number 3, Skylar McCune. Number 6, Lydia Yost. Number 7, Morgan Sengel. Number 11, Avery Meckling. Number 12, Shayna Russell. Number 13, Lauren Anderson. Number 14, Savannah Shelburne. Number 19, Avery Coleman. Number 27, Josie Mason. Number 28, Emma Prentice. Number 36, Brooklyn Schuler. Number 38, Sydney Huffman. And number 55, Kennedy Schecker. The assistant coaches are Kylie Holland, Lauren Polacek, Ashley Hall, Wendy Alexander, and Sarah Schramm. The head coach in his 19th season, Mike Brandon. Tonight's officials are Tanya Mulder and Isaac Russell. The bench official is Craig Weedle. Our line judges are Eric Williams and Leanne Borma. And now, let's play state championship volleyball!
Here we go, Class A state championship on the line, our final of the day.
And everybody is excited. This place is rocking.
The Titans of Papillion-La Vista South coming in at 22 and 17 on the year. The Dragons from Gretna, coached by Mike Brandon, at 28 and 10 on the year. There's a look at Mike Brandon. Years on the bench for the Dragons. 13 trips to state, two runner-up in 12 and 15. First year head coach Katie Wright, we told her yesterday, at least you aren't sitting the bar too high. First year in here at the state championship. She's a former Marion grad, played at Marion under Rolfs, coached there for a couple of years, came back home to Nebraska after spending time in California, and now leading this Titan program. Underway here in set number one in the Class A state championship. Off the top of the block goes Lydia Yost, knocked down, and the kill for the Dragons. Back to serve now for Gretna. Skylar Janovich-McCune. McCune with the serve, nice serve, pulled back in, bump set. Out of the back row. And the attack and the kill out of the back row point for the Titans.
Just nice aggressive back row swing, you know, utilizing that wide court in front of you, really making players move. Good tip.
Left hand not down. Off the block, great up. Pushed outside, swing by Hendricks. Hendricks got the kill. Sophie Hendricks.
Both these teams, we're gonna see scrappy defense here in this match. Both of them very assertive, going after balls. We saw a couple of them here in this last rally. Be prepared, we're gonna see that the rest of the night.
Left-handed swing, not down from Coleman. Hendricks again, tried deep corner. McCune is there. Swing, long, no touch. Titans with another point. Well, these two teams have squared off, as you said, Kathy, once earlier this year. It was early on, maybe before the midway point of the season, and Papillion-La Vista South won that over Gretna. 2-1 in a tight battle, but both of these teams, I think they would tell you they feel much different now than they did even at that moment.
Definitely, they feel different, we look different in our lineups and kind of what things that we are doing. We've changed, we've evolved. It's been a journey in this season to get to this point. And again, what we look like at early on is not who we are now.
Dynamic swing there by Alea Clark. And then on the other side, kill by Yost.
Lydia Yost on that outside. She averaged 9.4 kills this season.
Checker with another tough serve.
Nice
play. Big block on the right side. Combo between Prentice and Coleman.
You kind of see that swing block. They both work and get in organization and swing and push that ball.
A 3-0 scoring run by Gretna. I have a feeling this is going to be a back and forth kind of match all night. A couple of teams that are gritty, compete, don't let balls drop, not really flashy, just solid, hard-nosed teams.
The gritty is a great description of both of these squads.
At the net, Emma Prentice, the junior middle, 6 foot, who will play at North Dakota State with the kill.
Prince is just going up big, aggressive. You're gonna see that aggressive play from both these teams.
Tip try, good up by Shecker.
Great pursuit.
Outside.
Nice swing. Emma Prentice again in that middle, getting in there. Coming up big. Look at that great defensive play, pops that up. Shecker really pursuing, staying nice and low.
Near ace it is.
Yes, indeed. 3-0 run here, tough serve. Talking about some adjustments to make there. Coach Wright talking with their serve receive.
Swing wide point for the Dragons.
Yost again on that outside. She's off to a good start, three kills.
And it is a 4-0 run for Gretna. They lead it 8-4, timeout by the Titans. Let's take a look at last year's title match.
The number one ranked Lincoln Pius Thunderbolts faced the second ranked Millard North Mustangs with the hope of taking home the 2018 Class A championship. The Mustangs had not lost one set in the state tournament and came into the match on fire. Seniors Emmy Grant and Paige Holdsworth each had 12 kills in the match and helped keep the ball rolling for Millard North. The Mustangs' momentum could not be stopped as they swept the Thunderbolts for the program's third state championship trophy.
And that was last year's state championship. The two teams in this year's state championship knocked off those two teams in the semifinals.
Yep.
Gretna with the win over Millard North, and it was the Titans sweeping Pius both last night.
So kind of say move over our turn. Stepping out here, and again, both of them played, again, great matches, gritty, scrappy games.
Not quite on top of it on the swing by Adami. Stella Adami wide right, and it's a 5-0 Gretna run. And Sangle continues the serve, the 5-4 defensive specialist. Another good serve by Morgan Sangle, pulls LeGrand well off the 10-foot line, and it is a 6-0 Gretna run.
Damie taking some big swings here, just can't get on top of that ball to get it in the court. Really, again, tough serving, pulling that setter off the net.
Damie roll shots that time, kept it alive. On the third touch, it's over, and that ends the run as the Titans draw back to within five.
I think Ava LeGrand there, able to make that play. Did a great job getting her hips and shoulders square so she could swing at that ball. Good job with her feet.
LeGrand just a sophomore. She is the setter. She'll also play one rotation on the right side as they rotate setters. So back to serve now for the Dragons is Lydia Yost. 1,000 career kills for Yost at Gretna on the slide. Off the top of the block, not down by Petrovich.
Nice swing.
Good dig by Valinch. McCune working hard over there on that left side. Continues to get the swing. They switch it up, go to the middle. Titans keep it up. Again to the middle, the tip. A inch there. Finally off the block. The kill by Ava LeGrand.
Both teams staying very organized, digging balls, keeping aggressive, taking swings. Nice finish for LeGrand.
And that was that rotation where she swings from the right side. Good swing just inside on that back line on a tough angle by McCune. There's Janovich McCune. She is the niece of Andy Janovich of the Denver Broncos, who just signed another multi-million dollar contract with the Broncos. Former Husker fullback. McCune again. McCune
unloads
with the kill.
Big swing there by McCune. Gets up. She has great elevation. Getting up and getting on top of that ball.
Making Uncle Andy proud.
Yep.
13-6. Fourth seeded Gretna on top early in this first set. And already the Titans have taken both of their timeouts. Katie Wright wants to talk it over. Good crowd on hand here tonight from Gretna. And a whiteout for these Dragons.
Both schools bring in nice crowds, a lot of fun, a lot of energy.
Well, it is an impressive looking team for these Dragons. Let's take a look at the two who are moving on to the next level. Northern Colorado is going to have the services of Kennedy Shecker, and Emma Prentice heads to North Dakota State. Out of the timeout, Gretna will serve with a 7-point advantage. Gretna hitting 300 here in set number one to the Titans 043. Pushed out to the pin, Adami with the kill.
There she got one. She's been hitting, just missing her mark. Been a little bit long, gone wide. Here she gets in a position, is able to get on top of that ball, drop it inside.
Felt like a little more controlled swing as well. Sometimes this environment early on before you settle in.
Absolutely. She's just a ninth grader.
Get a little adrenaline flowing. Yeah, another ninth grader.
Yeah, another ninth grader we talk about throughout the day. Young talent.
There really is a lot of young talent in the state. Back to serve for the Titans. Angelia Petrovic. Petrovic, Serbian. Had 14 digs in the semifinals against the Thunderbolts. Good quick run and the touch and the kill by Emma O'Neill.
O'Neill, nice job. We saw Gretna really run and chase and kind of trying to get back organized after they sent that free ball over. She does a great job and just dropping it right into that center court area.
McCune gets the kill. Couldn't tell if Yost got that on the overpass or if the overpass did not make it back.
Regardless.
McCune or Yost with the kill. Good swing by Brecken Moore. Brecken, a junior, 5'7", outside hitter, but as the coaches said last night, her arm's like a slingshot.
And just a lot of space you can see in there between those blockers. She had a lot of court to look at.
The slide and the kill, Gretna back up by 5.
Coming around on that slide. She really does a nice job pushing it to the pin, making those blockers try and adjust. That's the hard part about a slide. You don't know exactly where that's going to be behind the center. It could be right behind her or all the way to the pin.
Sophie Hendricks with the kill from the left side, the 5'9 senior. And Coach Katie Wright said, she's my hero.
Great kid. Really stepped in, played well this season.
She wasn't going to play, remember?
Yep, she talked about, I think I'm just tired and worn out, and my passion is gone. And coach talked with her and convinced her, and she's been incredible season, and done a great, been a great leader for this team, and is actually now going on to play at Wayne State.
Yep, and playing for a state title.
Yep. So, just a decision, and I'm sure she's pleased with it.
You bet.
That ended up being.
There's There's Ava LeGrand again.
She's working hard on that right side. She does a, what I really like is she does a great job getting her body in a good position with that ball so that she gives herself options to attack.
Swing wide. And back to within one of the Titans. And a timeout taken by Mike Brandon. His first timeout of set number one. Papillion-La Vista South on an 8-2 run. Make it 15-14.
Seems like they're getting their offense going a little bit more, kind of getting settled in, and seem to be finding different people to be contributing or be effective.
Good crowd on hand here tonight. There's a look at Ava LeGrand, number 11 for the Titans. She has a lot of looks. She's just a sophomore, 6 foot setter, has all the tools to be outstanding. She has the bloodlines as well. Yes. She's related to Gabby and Tatum Ailes. She has two sisters, Reagan. One plays at USC. Mara plays at Regis. And she's getting a lot of looks from a lot of folks as just a sophomore. And she really plays a dual role here. She will hit on the right side, primary setter. But they need her offense as well. And you can see 5 kills early on, hitting 364. Blasted through the block, and the kill by Lydia Yost.
Yost is very dynamic. She's very quick with her feet. And here she does a nice job staying behind that ball and really being aggressive with it.
End of the net with a quick swing by Alea Clark. Back to serve now for Gretna, Kennedy Schecker. Good pass on point by Valinch. Schecker with the bump set. Valinch with the up. Nice roll shot by Sophie Hendricks.
Great job there to make an adjustment, taking a ball better in it.
Hendricks now back to serve. Into the block. Alea Clark was there. There's Clark, junior middle. Also throws the shot and the discus in track. And that is an ace right on the back line. Hendricks drops it in and says hello.
Here you get a chance to see it right on that line. Schecker was there, but it thought it was going. Great reactions there, strong plays.
Left-handed swing from that right side, not down. Off the touch, point Gretna.
Great work there to keep going after that ball. Block wasn't quite there, but she didn't stop, kept going. Prentice there.
Big block on the right side. Anderson was there along with Prentice.
Solid, strong. So important on that block that you don't just go up, but you go up with those shoulders shrugged and solid. That kind of locks them in right up.
Oh, nice hand up by Hendricks to keep it up.
This hesitation communication there. We're seeing great defense. We talked about these two teams, gritty, scrappy. Great up there, and then again, letting that ball drop in between. Just communication, clean that up.
Better pass. Pulled inside, Yost with the swing, not down. Leaves it for LeGrand. Rolls it off the top of the block. Now the middle, Prentice got the kill. Emma Prentice, junior middle, 6 foot, averages 5 kills a set.
She is working up there. She's been busting to the pins on the block. Here she gets it back in transition. Touch called.
They want a touch and they got it. Back official called the touch. Up official changed the ruling and the point for the Titans.
Here we get a chance to see.
Yeah, you can see the finger.
Fingers.
Yep.
Fingers. Good call. You got to rely on those line judges.
Out of the back row again. Not down in the swing by Hendricks. Tip to the deep corner is wide.
Good idea. Just missed the mark.
Now in for the Dragons, number 11, Avery Mackling. A senior serve specialist. Prentice not down. That was Schuler not down with the swing. McCune got it. Gretna extends it to a 3-point lead. Titans out of timeouts and Gretna just 3 away.
It's a really nice job staying behind that ball.
Out of the back row, Hendricks not there. The touch able to keep it alive. McCune, roll shot. Good reaction there by Alea Clark. McCune off the block.
Great pursuit out of bounds.
Breckenmore got the kill. Boy, at 5'7", Coach, and I don't know how she's going to play right side, and she has just found a way to do it.
Figuring it out, making big plays, playing strong.
Angelia Petrovic in to serve. Good pass. Powers it and falls on the Papillion-La Vista south side. 2 away.
Blockers there, just again a little bit early and a little bit off the net.
To serve now is Lauren Anderson. She will serve and set out of the back row.
Great set.
Good decision, yeah. Out to McCune, double block up on her. They put it down right into the hands of Emma O'Neill, who got the block. Not done yet.
Nope. Just a great, again, pursuit of ball. Never quit on a ball.
Block again. That time Clark was there, along with Moore. The last few times, it's just been tossed up to that left pin, and the block has been there, and a timeout taken by Mike Brandon as the Titans are back to within one.
Yep. Both of Pilling South middles really working, busting to that outside. And even if they weren't closed, they're going up strong.
Dragons with a point would be a point away and have at least a couple of opportunities at set point. Titans trying to pull even at 23. The last Papillion-La Vista South lead was 3-2. And they're within one now. Katie Wright's squad has broken the huddle on the far court. I'll remind you that you can get a DVD copy of these state high school championships by calling 800-868-1868 or visit our website, netnebraska.org. Just $19.95 plus shipping and handling. You can relive all this excitement from this year's championships for years to come. Valinch with the serve. Out of the middle, they pulled McCune in, and she misfires wide. So Brandon had the play drawn up that he wanted, had pulled McCune in, got the set he wanted, had open floor, but misfired wide, and we're knotted at 23. McCune blocked. All of a sudden, Alea Clark's block has become big.
Clark's just positioned herself in the right spot each time and then been up very strong, very physical.
First lead for the Titans since it was 3-2. They're on a 4-0 run and an opportunity to take set one here. That time, McCune powered the block back just enough to get the kill. Extra points here in the first set as McCune goes back to serve. Dig by McCune in that back row. Tip, got it. Big shot.
Lydia Yost coming up big here. Just really great dig. I mean, we talk about digs give you an opportunity to win points, and that's exactly what happened there.
Set point here for Gretna. Roll shot, not down. They'll have a swing for it. Yost, not down, good up. The tip try. Kept alive. Another chance. Yost again. Hendricks found the floor. Tied at 25.
Sophie Hendricks staying with it, staying aggressive. Look at that nice high hand, just placement. And between the two defenders.
25 all, both teams with 15 kills, both teams hitting right around 115. The difference here late has been that Titan block.
Absolutely. Clark has been a key part of that. Here LeGrand as well. Set up, and look at the two of them, up solid.
There wasn't an empty seat after that block on the Titans bench. Again, got it. Set one. Papillion-La Vista South. And that is a tough one to give away for Gretna. The fight late by the Titans. They take set number one, 29. 25-27.
The money that comes from Constellation goes directly back into our county 4-H program. So they're directly impacting young people and the development of young people, whether that's leadership development, citizenship development, or helping them develop life skills.
Constellation provides natural gas for Nebraska homes, farms, ranches, and businesses. Through our support for 4-H and FFA, we're providing energy for Nebraska's future as well. Natural gas from Constellation.
Participating in multiple Nebraska high school activities has taught me the value of teamwork.
I learned how to be a strong leader among my peers.
We set goals as a team and work hard to accomplish them.
I strive to excel not only in the classroom, but on the playing field.
The Nebraska School Activities Association, providing opportunities in 25 activities for our member high schools. NSAA activities, the other half of education.
Interactive exhibits for all ages bring sports to life at the Nebraska High School Sports Hall of Fame. Nebraska's history of high school sports is alive, while historic memorabilia preserve the rich heritage.
The Nebraska High School Sports Hall of Fame is for fans of all high school sports, like me.
Inside the NSAA headquarters at 500 Charleston Street, just north of Haymarket Park in Lincoln. More information at nebhalloffame.org.
After concussion, returning to the classroom is a priority of the NSAA. All brains return to learn. Not all brains return to play.
After recognizing that an athlete has suffered a concussion, it is important to monitor the symptoms in the classroom before allowing the athlete to return to extracurricular activities.
The NSAA requires coaches in all sports to take a concussion course once every 3 years.
More information is available on our website, nsaahome.org. Student athletes are students first, athletes second.
Well, it has been an emotional, difficult, and tragic year for the Gretna Dragons. Mike Brandon's daughter, Rowan, was the only survivor of that crash on June 17th that killed four Gretna High School students. Alex Minardi, Addison Pfeiffer, Chloe Odermatt, Abigail Barth. Rowan is the youngest of Mike and Kelly's three daughters. She suffered burns and a broken collarbone and spent 3 weeks right here in Lincoln at St. E's Medical Center. Mike, he told his assistants, he might not return to coach this year, but got some advice from someone very close to him. With more on that, let's go to Ryan Mix.
Yeah, thank you, Larry. Mike visited with his daughter, Roan, and wanted to get her thoughts whether or not he should return to the bench. And Roan said that she felt like it would be weird if he was not coaching because Roan wanted to be a part of the team this year. And after that discussion with Roan and his family, Brandon ultimately decided to return to coaching, and Roan has been on the bench with the Dragons throughout the season. And Gretna has just received an outpouring of support, not just from their community, but from other communities across the state. This past summer, a number of schools posted pictures from their coaches and student athletes wearing green with the hashtag #GoGreenForGretna. And it's just been an extremely emotional year for this team, and for them to be in this position obviously means a lot, not just for Mike and Roan, but for the entire community.
Yeah, and here are some of those pictures. Thank you, Ryan. The team is wearing ribbons in remembrance of those four girls. Those ribbons vary in color from orange, green, blue, and yellow for those lost lives this summer. Talk to Mike Brandon about it, and as he said, that obviously an accident and tragedy like that is going to have a tremendous impact on families, on those who are impacted directly, on the student body, on the community. But they put together a plan. They got together with their leadership team. They came up with a plan on how to move forward and handle it. They've executed on that plan, made a game plan. And he said all we could do is just go to work. About everything that was going on at that time, and this would have been, you know, late spring, early summer. The flooding was just happening.
Right. Our state was experiencing that as well, and again, everybody pulling together, and that's the key. Relying on one another and working to move forward.
Another point for the Titans as they take a 3-1 lead here in set number two. Hendricks is back serving for the Titans. Powering through that block, killed by Prentice.
Prentice really getting in aggressive hard. That block has been an issue, and late in set number one. So knowing she's got to go up and go up strong.
Swing by a Damien, not down. Yost with the tip try. LeGrand spun and tried to keep it alive, but the kill for Yost.
Yost now with 7 kills leading the Dragons. She's had a great tournament. She had 18 and 19 so far. So really playing strong here.
And there is Gretna's block coming up bit on the right side. Anderson, the setter.
Prentice and Anderson, as you mentioned. Big blocks, both teams having to face.
Serve just long to even it at 4. A trying season on the floor for the Titans, as you know, they lost Emma O'Neill for a while, who was one of their only middle hitters. They only have two middle hitters. You lose one, and all of a sudden, you start thinking, well, what are we going to, how are we going to play in the middle? How do you adjust? And after struggling through, you know, a stretch where they lost to Pius 10th, Southwest, North Star, Lincoln East, Katie Wright got together and with her coaches, and they put a plan together to really rethink about, to rethink the way the rotation would look.
Well, just not a traditional, you're a middle and you play middle three rotations up in the front. Some people were paying it one rotation, somebody two, somebody else. And so really took the kids that they had, because we're missing a middle. We're taking the kids and we're making a system designed to take advantage of what we do have. And she said, kids, you're gonna have to trust me. On this. This is not traditional, but this is what we need to do. I believe it's going to work for us. And honestly, they really embraced it, and they played really well. And it was honestly maybe a little bit difficult after O'Neill came back to change out of that system, because it was working so well, and wanted, had to work through that adjustment too.
That brushes the antenna is out. One of the difficult conversations that Katie Wright said she had to have after that, after O'Neill came back, was with Harley Cole, who was just a sophomore outside hitter who had stepped up and played tremendously well while O'Neill was out, and saying, going to her and saying, this is kind of sport. This is what, it's nothing you did. You did exactly what we asked you to. You excelled when you had the opportunity. You stepped up when your chance came, and this is just what happens in athletics sometimes.
And again, you did nothing wrong. That's part of the whole process. That's part of sports too. And again, those are life lessons. And again, I guess really prepares you for life.
Yep. There is Harley Cole, the sophomore outside hitter.
Again, key player for this team, just taking on different roles. Not less value, just different.
Sometimes also it's, we don't put ourselves in the train of thought about even the players who are sitting and who are contributing in practice and making others around them better, how many individuals they have beat out just to make this team, and how many high-level quality athletes don't even get an opportunity to play on a 14-team roster, varsity roster. That's really, you know, it's not like you can have unlimited number of players on.
Absolutely. And again, the practice players are what make those starters better, or push them to challenge them for their positions and those kind of things. So everyone has a key role in the team being where they are, 1 through 14.
Petrovic now will serve for the Titans, down by two, and the ace by Petrovic.
And tough serve there.
Her student body classmates, as she served, chanting Serbia. She's a Serbian native. LeGrand out to Hendricks. Great dig by Yost. And then the solo block right after that, Emma O'Neill.
She's looking pretty healthy out there right now. It was just her. She took it all and gets it all.
Kept alive. One on one. Brooklyn Moore with the kill on the right side. Took advantage of a very good set decision right there.
Set decision and a lot of real estate in front of her. She only had one blocker. She had a lot of space, a lot of court to swing.
Overpass and a little too aggressive.
Clark wants that one back. Felt good, came up. Talk about a great athlete, Clark, shot and discus, track athlete. But again, you can see out here how athletic she is. Nine,
Lopez, and a solo block on the other side for Hendricks. Looked like Coleman had that lane to swing through and right into the block of Hendricks. Clark was late getting there.
Hendricks then made that adjustment. You can see if that middle isn't getting closed, you kind of stay inside and protect that hard angle.
Yost tools the block of LeGrand. Back and forth again here in set number two. Kind of got the feeling coming into this state championship in Class A that, you know, Papillion-La Vista was the number one team, but they hadn't really been challenged all year, right? 36-1, hadn't had big moments where they were heavily stressed. Millard North was the defending state champ, and they were seeded number eight because of the having to forfeit, you know, 14 matches. They came in at 10-24. Gretna, obviously, here. Millard West, Elk South, Papillion-La Vista South, Pius 10th, Millard South, any one of those teams, you know, get hot at the right time,
right,
go on a run, big and key moments late, any one of those could have been here this year.
True, a lot of disparity. I mean, it was really an open field. Anybody had an opportunity. It was really about excelling and playing well at the right time. And we've talked about both these coaches and said, we are playing our best right now. Yep. I mean, we're fortunate it is now. LeGrand again. You know, you think about her, what she does as that setter, but also she is an offensive threat. She's got eight kills in the match, hitting over 250.
Serve is long. 13-12 Gretna. Yost back to serve. Tried the angle, but a little bit too sharp as LeGrand wide makes it 14-12. McCune into the big block.
O'Neill really did a good job with her footwork, working to get to that outside.
Blocks heavily in favor of Papillion-La Vista South, 10-4. And an ace.
Talking about blocking really late in set number one, that block really was a key factor, and they've just continued on. They've really been consistent with that block. Nice chair there by McCune. Driving it through.
And down, back to nine at 15, and that is the eighth tie in set number two already, and we're at 15 apiece.
Back and forth.
Petrovic back in to serve. Good pass. Around the middle. Can't get it down to the swing by Schuttler. Hendricks unloads. Nice dig. Yost. Schuttler tries it again. Into the net. Called on the Titans. Anderson back to serve. Anderson headed to Morningside to play volleyball and study nursing. Solo block.
Stayed tight there. Coleman. Great delay, great timing.
first right to the block of O'Neill.
O'Neill is patrolling the net. She is working pin to pin, working her tail off to get those blocks closed, and it's paying off.
11 blocks for the Titans to 5 for Gretna. That time told the block on the kill by McCune. Janovich McCune will now go back to serve. Just a sophomore already thinking about Creighton, BYU. And the double block. And a little pounding of the floor by Avery Coleman for emphasis.
Getting a little stretch here, and those big blocks really helping the cause.
Ashlyn Dirks in to serve for the Titans. Biggest and best leader on the team, according to Coach Katie Wright. She's the one that brings the team together, very inclusive, concerned about team unity, team orientation. And the kill there by Schuler. And for the second straight set, Gretna, the first team to 20. And the Titans will take the timeout. Well, it has been a block party for Papillion-La Vista South. The Titans have been Titan-esque at the net.
Definitely 11 blocks so far in this match. You can just see the efforts of many folks here. Obviously Clark working hard in the middle, but also we're seeing O'Neill making some great plays in the middle. But you got to credit your outsides. They're the ones who set that block up. The middles have the task of working to close, but those outsides are the key in setting up. And really, what an intimidating factor and making it difficult, making attackers make adjustments when that block is up and hard to get around.
Leia Clark, part of that block party for the Titans. 5 blocks for Clark and 5 for Emma O'Neill. 4 for LeGrand, 4 for Brecklin Moore. Great up in the back row, diving effort by McCune. Keep it alive and then into the antenna, gives the point to the Titans. So out of the timeout, Titans take advantage. Hendricks back to serve. Kill on the left side. Adami with the kill. Stella Adami.
Adami is very athletic. She's off that neck. Look at that elevation. Really uses those high hand of the block, tools it.
Tip kept alive by LeGrand. Yost will try again, that time off the top of the block. Knocked down. The Lynch was there. Bump set out of the net.
Great play out of the net.
A pace ball there by Yost.
Yost 9 kills. Again, just finding a way. That ball wasn't in great position. Still made a strong move.
Tough serve. Pulled off the net.
Just hesitation. Yep. Blocked it what it needed to. Slowed the ball down. Just some hesitation by the defenders.
There's a look at Harley Cole, who's now in to serve. A dig by Cole. Out of the back row, Hendricks. set the middle. Not down for Schuler.
Great tempo shot.
Tip try, got it. Gretna three away as Lydia Yost back to serve. Back in for the Titans comes Alea Clark. And also the girl back in, Delaney Valinch. Tried deep corner, caught the defender off guard and got the kill. Now two away. Titans still have a timeout, and Katie Wright is going to take it right now. First-year head coach for the Titans, 20-17 in year number one, and making it to the state championship. These Titans won titles in three consecutive years, 2010, 11, and 12. They made it into the finals five straight years, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now the setter for the Titans, Ava LeGrand, who also swings a bit from the right side. She's had a nice match. Here she is out of the back row.
She's got 9 kills, hitting 214. She's also got 8 assists, so she's not far from having a double-double. She's also one of those great players who plays some strong defense. She's 8 digs, so she's got complete package there. Again, playing a dual role of being a setter and an attacker.
The timeout, back row attack for Hendricks, or check that for LeGrand.
Yep.
The tip try. LeGrand is in the front row. Oh, aggressive swing by Yost, not down. Tip,
yep.
Got it. What a tip kill, Adami. Stella Adami with the kill.
Adami was up in the air, and it looked like she was just up there looking, where do I need to place this? You know, great defense in play. Hendricks playing big there, really fed that up. Yeah, we talk about it all the time. Defense, again, we say it over and over, leads to points.
Good, quick run in the middle. Set the one, and Prentice put it down.
Prentice is pretty tough up there. She's got 9 kills, hitting over 400. She's doing it all, blocking, getting back in that offense.
Gretna with an opportunity to tie it at a set apiece right here. And they do, big block. Schuler comes up big. And Gretna takes set number two. 25-21. Settle in. We're at 1-1 here in the Class A title. Both of these teams in each of the first two sets showing a little grit. 1-1 here in Class A.
Are you ready? Let's go.
4 years of high school can prepare your girls for who they'll be the rest of their life. That's why it's important for students at Marion to have every opportunity to develop in the arts, the sciences, all academics, as confident, faith-filled leaders in their community, and beyond. The journey begins here. Marion High School. Discover what lies ahead.
Not just on the good days. Not just on the challenging ones. Not just during business hours. Or when relaxing. But always. For the past 125 years, Farmers Mutual of Nebraska, always alongside you.
Whether it's spring planting, fall harvesting, or just a drive across the state,
Soy biodiesel helps a diesel-powered engine operate in a demanding job. Soybean oil from Nebraska soybeans makes biodiesel a renewable fuel that's also environmentally responsible. The Soybean Checkoff plays a major role in supporting the use and availability of biodiesel. The Nebraska Soybean Board, growing opportunity from the ground up.
I'm Nicole Brungart, and I'm a part of the U.S. Women's Bobsled Team. I'm a four-time All-American, and I'm from Norfolk, Nebraska. Bobsledding was definitely not in the picture when I was growing up, but I'm thankful to be where I'm at, and I'll never take that for granted. In my career, I'm getting bumped around, bruised in the back of the bobsled, so it's super important that I keep up with my sleep, my nutrition, seeing my trainer, seeing the chiropractor, and staying in the gym so I can be at the top of my game when competition comes.
Welcome back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center in the Class A State Championship. Gretna and Papillion-La Vista South are tied at one heading into the third set. Papio South will have to face a little adversity and bounce back after dropping the second set. And at 22-17, this is something that Papio South has had to do this year. And head coach Katie Grant said she thought the turning point in the season was when her team realized how important mental toughness is. They were going through a funk in September, and at one point, Katie Grant gave up practice and had the team do mental drills because she thought it was so important. She said everyone has volleyball skills, but not everyone has mental toughness. So they spent an entire practice doing mental drills, and it's been a little bit of a different tune since then. They were 15-16 in mid-October, but they've won seven of their final eight, and we'll see how their mental toughness is here at the state final.
Wasn't that the truth of every great team? I mean, that's so important to be able to stay in the moment, not let what might happen or what you think can happen or beyond the next point.
Yep, you got to take it one point at a time, and you got to have a short memory and move on. If things aren't going well, it's done. Learn from it. Prentice is really getting aggressive, getting out there, getting after it offensively in transition.
Get a rule shot. LeGrand with the kill.
LeGrand, as we've mentioned, just a sophomore, but very wise. Look at that open area in the court. She sees that. She's just got such good vision of the court. She's been around it. We've talked about, again, the family, her sister. Just really a very educated volleyball player.
Good up there. Oh, what a great shot by LeGrand. Didn't try to fire through the block, didn't try to blast it inside, saw the open court near the back line and just gently set it right over the block.
High IQ. High volleyball IQ. Great push to the outside. Nice. Look how fast Adami is. Wow.
Sent back over by Clark. Over the top of the block and down. Good kill by Coleman.
Yeah, just a great shot selection. Controlled that ball right into the gap. Good high hand, look at that. You know, that lefty on her on hand side really putting herself in a position to swing aggressively, be smart.
And tried the tip. Shecker kept it alive. Bump set. Out to Adami, that's long.
Touch.
And there was a touch. Stella Adami with the kill.
I'm enjoying watching her. We talked about just a young player, but she is fast. She has very quick feet. Doing a nice job, and as you said, she will continue to evolve as she grows and grows into her experiences.
The block Good up by Cole.
Straight up. Also coming from that left side.
No touch. And four hits. Into the net.
Yep.
Point for Gretna, 5-4.
Prentiss, I believe, 11. That puts her leading Dragons.
Match has a very different feel to it than those that we've witnessed all day long. The others have been big runs by each team, 5-6 runs at a time. Coaches calling timeout. This has a very side out, back and forth, methodical grinder feel to it.
Yep, and some long rallies. I mean, we're seeing great defensive plays, staying organized.
Got a hand on that one.
Yep, Anderson taking that angle shot away.
Off the top of the block by McCune. Back row swing by Yost is wide. Point for the Titans.
Out of system, Yost. I like her taking that aggressive swing. Just didn't finish it.
Kept it alive. McCune tried to go deep corner, caught the wrong side of it.
Just didn't get her hand on that ball good. You're trying to take that down line. You got to have that full hand on there, control.
Serve is long. Effort on the swing by Moore, knocked down. And the left-handed kill by Coleman.
And really kind of ended up coming right at LeGrand, but her vision and sight on the ball was lost. The off blocker coming off. You see there, Moore kind of obstructed her vision.
Moore again, and there, one-on-one, and Moore put it down.
Great set decision, Moore. Great finish.
Back to serve now for the Titans. Delaney Valinch. McCune powering through the block of Clark. And McCune with the kill.
McCune been a little bit quiet here. Big swing for her. Really need her. And just really beats the block, blows it through the arms.
She's had 40 kills in the first two matches down here at State for the Dragons.
Great save.
Reckland not down. Run it in the middle and got it. Kill by Schuler.
Nice quick transition there. Really key in winning that point. Look at that ball up and right there.
And again, the undersized right side. Brecklin Moore with another kill.
LeGrand is really putting her in a great position, but also again, Clark, she's pulling that middle away, giving that one-on-one, and LeGrand sending it back.
Hendricks tried to keep it alive, and the tip works. Back to even at 10. Kennedy Schecker. Over 1,000 career digs for Gretna with the serve. Good up. Schecker with a nice reaction. Hendricks. Block touch on it to keep it alive. Yost does not clear the tape.
And they fought for that.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Back to serve now goes Sophie Hendricks. Bump set Yost from off the net. Again, that one sent back off the hand of Clark. LeGrand. Killed by LeGrand. What a night Ava LeGrand is having. 13 kills, 10 assists, 10 digs, 4 blocks.
That's a super sophomore.
Wow. Dynamite player. Serve long. For LeGrand.
Make that 14. Just keep them coming. So just again, smart decision, and she's getting a lot of them by smart decisions. She's also being aggressive, swinging up there at different times, but when it's not in a position for her to do that, she still takes some advantage and comes up with a kill.
There's LeGrand again with the block. Keeps this up, she's gonna have a quadruple double.
Yep.
Blocks.
How many people can say that? That's a complete game. All facets.
Blasting through the block of LeGrand is Yost.
That big block up there, the Titans, you gotta really be aggressive, and Yost fires that one through, knocks them apart.
Look at this third set, and it's gone 9-8, 9-9, 10-9, 10-10, 11-10, 12-10, 12-11, 13-11, 14-11, 14-12. It's just been back and forth.
One exchange with another.
You can see why they missed Emma O'Neill when she was out with that stress fracture.
She's got 6 blocks, 3 kills, hitting 30, well, over 300, probably about 350.
So the Gretna Dragons trailing by 4 here. Timeout taken by Mike Brandon. Emma Prentice trying to keep these Dragons in it as she has 11 kills, hitting 417.
She's also, I mean, just we see right here appearing different locations. And then she's been the middle of that blocking scheme, pin to pin. She's been working hard, really late, probably the second half of this match so far. She's really got more involved in the offense and really that's where she's upped her game.
Good numbers for Prentice. Five blocks to go with 11 kills, hitting 417. Grand to serve. Prentice got a good swing there. Block sent back. The touch into the net called on the Titans. Net violation gives the point to the Dragons. Back to serve now for the Dragons. Avery Macklin. Tough serve by Macklin. On the slide, there's Brecklin Moore again.
Moore's doing a tremendous job. And again, decision making is giving her a great, putting her in a great position to be effective, but she's coming through. She's doing exactly what they need her to do.
Look at the hitting percentage this set, 312 for the Titans, under 120 for Gretna. Two touches. Two hits called on the Titans. Gretna down by three. Had an opening there, tried to cut it a bit too much, and it's wide off the swing of Brecklin Moore. Back to within two are the Dragons. A quick run on offense, and Emma O'Neill with the kill.
Transition in there. Emma O'Neill. See, you can see she's between the two blockers, so where that attack that requires both of them to move in to try and close that gap.
Did not clear the net on the swing by Hendricks.
Trying to take a little bit off of it and just her timing and got out of sorts.
Back row McHugh, just long. Thought maybe they had that back line, but long and no touch point for the Titans. Back up to a 3-point lead for Papillion-La Vista South.
The Titans there trying to go up and stop that.
Good shot by Hendricks. Titans the first to 20 for the first time in the match.
Great job coming back with a big swing. Talk about a big swing. Prentice goes up hard every time. She just go her work ethic out there as a middle, getting in, just quick.
Great swing. Nice up. The save of the swing by Adami. Leave it here for LeGrand, not down. Kept alive by McCune and down.
Great up here. Defense leading to this next point. Just laying it all out there. And nice finish.
Ace! Oh. And the ace by Sengel, Morgan Sengel. Junior DS and server.
Look at that movement on that ball. Wow.
Good smart play by Hendricks.
LeGrand, I believe that was again.
Check that, it was LeGrand.
Yep. Here you can see again this whole area. Just open that. The defense pinched in. She just knows. She just sees what's happening out there and just is making smart plays.
That went off the block and we're back to even. Seven ties here in set number three. Here's a big swings that got blocked, touches on him. LeGrand again, that time takes it a little bit off it, and Ava LeGrand with another kill.
Make that 17 for that young lady. Again, you think, oh, she's running the offense. She's a setter.
Yeah.
She is equally as effective in her hitting role, if not more.
Into the ball. And the Titans started to pull away here late. And a timeout taken by Gretna. Final timeout for Mike Brandon. Two away from going up 2-0. Good crowd on hand tonight for both of these schools. The student sections have absolutely shown up. Theme on one side and a whiteout on the other.
They have been fun too.
Yeah. Let's take a look at the Titans, who are leading at 23-21. Hendricks, the 5'9 outside hitter, the senior who has played well here tonight. I think Coach Katie Wright says one of the smartest players I've coached.
She's my hero. I think were her words.
Her hero, very poised, gonna miss her next year. Glad she decided to play. If there was a superlative, it was meant for Hendricks. Prentice from off the net, got a good swing on it. Nice dig. Sent back on the swing from Moore. Other side, McCune off the top of the block. Moore again. Fire it back to that left pin, and it's Doug. Out of the back row, Hendricks knocked down. Joust at the net. Emma O'Neill with the kill. And the Titans at 24 and a point away from this set and going up 2-1. They'll serve for it. Pass and a Devaney. Long. In to serve now for the Dragons. Macklin. Options up front for the Titans. O'Neill and a Devaney. And the serve is long and the Titans take control. To South with a lead here, 2-1, fourth coming up. Can they close it out? Come back and find out.
Early mornings, late nights, emotionally, physically, mentally tougher. Generations of trust, innovation, and hard work done side by side. The decisions you make for your land and livestock have a direct impact on your operation, the region, and the world. That is why we're there when you need us anytime, every time. We both have one chance, one season, one mission,
tougher together. Aurora and you.
The morning doesn't always start when you want it to. It starts when it has to. And day or night, we're up when you are. Through the good times, through the tough times. For the necessary and the unexpected. Even when you don't need us at all, we're just a light switch away. And when it's finally time to call it a night, we keep the lights on, ready to do it all over again. Nebraska Public Power District. Powering your every day, every day.
FFA's vision is to build leaders, grow communities, and strengthen agriculture.
The funds from Constellation will most likely be directed to one of those areas. But most importantly, people need to know that it is at the local level. It's helping local chapters.
Constellation provides natural gas for Nebraska homes, farms, ranches, and businesses. Through our support for 4-H and FFA, we're providing energy for Nebraska's future as well. Natural gas from Constellation.
Hi everyone, the NET production remote truck is on location, ready for another live sports broadcast. Here's your invitation to become a member of the Sports Partners Club and help ensure the great sports we all love continue on NET. Member benefits include invitations to things like production facility tours, meet and greet events, and tailgate parties. Thanks to the support of NET Sports Partner Club members, NET is Nebraska's home for sports. Become a member of the NET Sports Partners Club.
Coverage of the 2019 NSAA Volleyball Championships on NET is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest, Nebraska Public Power District, Constellation, and Aurora Cooperative. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. We're back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center along with Kathy Wieskamp. I'm Larry Putney. It's great to have you with us. Ryan Mix is patrolling the sidelines, the court side, and it is 2-1. The Titans on top of the Dragons for the Class A State Championship.
And this has been like none other we've had all day.
Right?
Back, forth, one at a time. That last set, we had over 22 ties. Here we go. Here's that ball. Right up. Wow.
Shecker.
She's been flying all over this court, too.
Yost into the block. One hands it up. Shecker with the set. Not down. Hendricks, swing not down.
Just a scramble play for a kill.
So not only back and forth, but long back and forth. Difficult to terminate.
Yep.
Tough to stay in system.
But they're staying organized even when they're out of system and keeping it alive. They're not making errors. They're still getting another shot off.
Big block by Hendricks. Gritty grinders.
Hendricks and Clark. Well,
it was Clark had a hand on it.
Again, she goes up strong. Even if she's not there, she's going up strong and taking away space.
Block again by Clark in the middle. Fires through the block of the kill by Brooklyn Schuler.
Schuler staying strong there, going up hard.
Tough serve by Shecker. Bump set out to the pin. LeGrand into the block and then miscommunication. It was the traffic more than the miscommunication.
Yep, just got caught up in it.
Ace! Shecker with the ace.
Only the third service ace, and actually the movement on that ball, it was moving out of bounds.
It was headed out.
There was a lot of movement. And if you don't know, you got to take it.
Another good serve leads to the free ball for Gretna. They give it right back. On the slide, LeGrand did not quite get on top of it. And Gretna up 4-3. By Schecker, out to Yost, tries the tip. Hendricks there. Second touch, it went over.
Wow.
Ennis, what a swing, but a better up.
Yeah.
Yost again off the block. 5-0, Gretna run.
They are coming out on fire.
Set out to Hendricks. Not moving quite a bit there. Could have been the ball. Good swings. Good defense by both squads.
And both being aggressive, mixing it up, trying to change it, things up, get the other team off balance.
Block. Prentice tried deep corner, not there. Lock back. And finally, Prentice with the block. 6-3, 6-zip run.
As you mentioned, long rallies. I mean, balls are not falling. We're having big power swings. We're tipping it. We're roll shotting, making people move. Both teams playing very well.
You wouldn't know that this is their third match in 3 days as quickly as they're moving. There's some great defense being played on both sides here. A look at first-year head coach Katie Wright. 11th trip down here to Lincoln for this Titans program. They've won it 3 times and finished runner-up 3. Wright talked about the legacy of so many coaches before her of here at the Titans, Gwen and Brad, the culture they've created. Needs to keep that culture going, likes the talent they have coming up, likes where the program is, likes the culture of the program. There was a time earlier this year when they started to struggle and people were injured and wondered if they were coming out, where they knew they had to keep the ship pointed in the right direction, and they've done that.
And right now they're sitting 2-1 in this final. You know, and she said, you know, we're in a good position. We just need to keep maintain that and keep looking at ways to elevate that as we go.
Yost sends a free ball over. To Clark, nice cover there provided by Hendricks. Back line.
Emma Prentice up there again, 13 kills. She's making things happen.
Leading the way for Gretna in terms of hitting percentage is Prentice. Got a touch on the block. Prentice off the side of the block, but Clark sends it back.
Clark there took away that angle this time. Back. She brings it back.
Devaney back into the game for the Titans. Strong front line here for the Titans. LeGrand, Devaney, Clark. Thought about attacking above the net until last second realized, wait, I'm back row.
Yep.
I need to stay below it and into the net.
Again, just kind of where that ball ended up in her positioning.
Yeah. Served by Sangle, ace.
Dropped that right on that baseline. You get a chance to see again. Driving that deep. Definitely great call.
Just wide. That stops a 9-1 Gretna run since the Titans opened up at 3-0. Back in now is Harley Cole. Harley is a sophomore. One of those who played such a big role when O'Neill was out. And Prentice again picks up kill number 14.
She just keeps coming at you. And again, they're ball handling well yep. enough for her to be able to be in the mix and in the offensive system. That's really been key.
Yeah, Lauren Anderson has done a nice job getting her the ball, making her a focus here in sets 3 and 4. Runs it to her again, does Anderson.
Great. Big hands there, just out of bounds.
He's off the side, didn't clear the net.
Yep.
Prentice again, top of the hands off the block and another kill.
And still, Prentice is only as good as the ball handling. Yeah. I mean, without that, she isn't part of the offense. And so you've really got to credit the back row play, getting that ball right where they need it to be able to run that system.
Tough serve. It'll be a free ball here for the Dragons, not down. Devaney with the kill. Boy, you could see she was ready to explode on that one. Yeah. Stutter step, and attacked.
She's so quick. You just watch her in transition. Watch her get to that outside, how fast she's able to get out there. Yes. That's what I wanted.
Great reaction from Stella Adami.
Talk to you. She's a young one. She's only going to grow in her abilities.
Block in the middle. O'Neill with another block. That is 8 blocks for O'Neill here in the match, and a total of 16
wow.
for the Titans.
Both teams, 16 and 9 are our numbers in the block category. We've talked about how effective and how important it's been.
O'Neill again with the touch of the kill.
And we've also talked about how smart
yeah.
these attackers have been. And another example.
Three zip run here for the Titans.
Another good pass.
Make it 4-0 run. All of a sudden we've gone from back and forth to a 3-0 run, a 9-1 run, and now a 4-0 run.
That's because we thought we knew what was happening. So it's
we should know better than that.
Yep, we don't. And in this game, you never know. Miscommunication there a little bit, but still stayed alive.
How about Gretna Moore?
Titans have taken advantage of that. Moore has really done a tremendous job on that right side. People are so focused on the other attackers, too, that when she gets her chance, though, she's delivered.
So both teams have used one timeout, and that last kill by Brecken Moore puts it at 11-11. This has been a tremendous blocking game for both of these teams. We talked about the 8 blocks that Emma O'Neill has, 6 blocks for Emma Prentice of Gretna. Here's a look at the numbers for the Titans. 8 for O'Neill,
mm-hmm.
7 for Clark, 5 for Moore, 5 for LeGrand.
Yep. Wow.
And a total of 16, 3 in this current set.
And we've also, I mean, that's just the termination blocks. I mean, the hands on the balls and those that are still covered and played up. It's really played a key role in this match.
Mike Brandon meeting with his team as they've given up a 5-0 scoring run and allowed the Titans to even it up. Back in there to serve now for the Titans is Petrovic, Angelia Petrovic. Anderson. Right on the line with a swing by McHugh.
That's what they needed to get that ball back. Stop the run.
Ace. Right inside the line. The ace by Schecker. Check that, Anderson with the ace. Set yep. Right there.
Yep. And again, she's serving at an angle from that middle position, kind of toward the edge of the court. All those angles make a difference. So do those blocks.
Brooklyn Schuler up front with the block. 3-0 run now for Gretna. Out of the timeout. Gretna has rattled off 3 straight to take the 14-11 lead. McHugh. Moore again. She just finds a way, huh?
Keep more and more you can count on Brooklyn Moore. She definitely has been a key factor here too. How many kills is that for her? 8. Just so, and if you look up and down again the statistics, just so balanced.
Genovitz McHugh back to serve. Hold. Into the net. Net violation called in the Dragons. Point for the Titans.
That tempo shot pulled those blockers in. They're up a little bit early, hanging in. A lot of times you try to see if you can hang up there a little longer and you pull yourself into the net.
They should have just started this fourth set at 20-20.
Oh.
You know it's going to get there. It's just going to be methodical and back and forth until we do get there.
Just that type of match so far. There's a great shot, too.
Brittis.
Just doesn't give you time to get back or organize and get two blockers up. That's that quick transition and the ball handling. Prentice right there. Said, give me the ball.
Last time out of this fourth set will be taken by Katie Wright. Gretna still with one left. Let's take a look at Lydia Yost, who has 15 kills, 9 errors, 64. Swings for Gretna. 10 digs. She's got a double-double.
Yep. She's one of those kind of spark plugs on the outside, really being aggressive on there that you see there. They pulled her in. Here she takes a ball that's off the net, still does something very positive with it. It's one of those players they've counted on all season long, really, from that outside. Her consistent play has been really a factor.
There is Lydia Yost, 15-10-2, the double-double.
She's one of those two, again, very energetic. She really brings a lot of energy and positivity to the court.
Yost again.
Great line shot, but nice up.
Up alive. Anderson, Yost in the middle. got it. They pull her inside and let her swing right about the 10-foot line, maybe just inside.
Yep, just mixing things up again, running that cross pattern. And they put sent Prentice to the outside and brought her inside. Inside out.
Swing is long and Gretna now on top by six here in set number four, trying to push this to a fifth and deciding set. That ends the 4-0 run by Gretna. Back to serve now for the Titans. Sophie Hendricks. Yost again. 17 kills for Lydia Yost.
Here again, they ran that crossing pattern, brought her inside and pushed Prentice out. Just a different look, a different person.
Kill for Yost.
What a stretch right here for her. She's got the hot hand, that's for sure. Using her on the outside here, kind of cuts that ball, gets it to go that angle shot. Little change there, and LeGrand gets involved and stops that short run.
In to serve is Harley Cole. And another point for the Dragons as they are three away from taking set number four. Papillion-La Vista South leads it 2-1 here in this Class A championship match. Prentice there with the touch to keep it alive. Anderson not down. LeGrand.
Nobody's
set
at all.
Right back out to LeGrand. The touch, got it. Smart shot by Ava LeGrand. That is 20 kills in the match for LeGrand. Now back to serve. Prentice. They're going to say it touched the defender. And wide, so it didn't matter. Well, now could the Titans claw their way back right into this?
Anything's possible in this match.
Prentice again there off the side is of the block. 17. And two away from a deciding fifth here in Class A. Set point. Back to serve for it. Avery Macklin. And just long. Set point number two coming up for the Dragons. Angelia Petrovic in to serve. Set point for Gretna, the second. Good pass, good set, good swing, not down. Same scenario. McCune with the kill. And we are headed to a fifth at the Devaney Sports Center. Could not be a more appropriate ending to a terrific day. We started this morning with a five-setter in Class D2, and we're going to end it with a five-setter in Class A. Mike Brandon with the fist pump. Gretna lives to see a fifth. Come back and see who takes home the trophy.
Next, we're joined by Lynn Messersmith, who is an Alliance writer and cowboy poet, as well as a third-generation rancher whose grandparents homesteaded in Cherry County in the late 1800s. Lynn, welcome.
I was born and raised here, and I guess my feet are full of sand. I've always loved to read poetry. I became involved in the cowboy poetry movement, which is a little bit different, but it's just basically storytelling in verse. I'm about Nebraska, and I'm a rural person, and so that's where my roots are. There's a connection with the audience. I'm basically an introvert, which you would not know, but you can become anybody when you're performing.
I don't know her name, this relative from the past in the faded photograph, looking proud. But not quite.
I like to listen to NET radio because, number one, you do the shows like Friday Live, which showcases different areas of the state, different people's professions, talents. One of my favorite programs is All Things Considered. We get viewpoints from all over, nationally, world viewpoints. I get both sides with the news. I can make up my own mind. If I believe in something, I believe I need to support it with my presence, my finances, and even to tell other people about it. I appreciate NET very much, and keep up the good work. I'm Lynn Messersmith from Alliance, Nebraska. I listen and support NET Radio.
Hi, Create viewers. I'm Bridget Lancaster.
And I'm Julia Collin-Davison from Cook's Country.
You're gonna love this. Coming up on Create is the new season of Cook's Country as a marathon. Binge watchers, get ready.
That's 6 hours of delicious classic dishes and everyday favorites.
Ooh, on the nose.
Nailed it, huh?
So I'm gonna start with the one I'm not crazy about. We're bringing America's best recipes home to you. You won't wanna miss it. Coming soon to Create.
There is Lydia Yost, encouraging her teammates in the huddle between sets, and you could clearly read her lips. I believe in you. Mike Brandon said she is the one that brings the energy every day. And she has brought it here tonight, leading this club with 18 kills.
Wow.
And has brought them back from behind to tie this at two, and now it is a sprint to 15.
This is anybody's match, anybody's championship. And we've talked about it before. Getting that quick start is really critical.
Here we go. A fifth and deciding for a state championship in Class A. Skylar Janovich McHugh to serve to start it off. Good set, pushed outside, left hand not there for Hendricks into the net. Net violation called on Gretna. Yep, on the way down.
His body wasn't balanced.
Schuler just brushed it, and the service error evens it at one. Back in comes Prentice for the Dragons. So she'll run her three rotations through the front and give Gretna some options. Back to serve, Shecker, and a service error.
Back and forth, one at a time.
Jamie back in for the Titans. Good serve by Hendricks. Left-handed swing, not down from Coleman. But Jamie off the block. Coleman got the hand on it. Graham with the tip. Anderson flips it out to Yost. LeGrand with the fingers to keep it alive. Oh, what a shot by LeGrand. Just a little pace ball deep corner.
defense is in the triangle kind of position, and that leaves those corners open in the back. And she's got a lot of control of the ball and just places it right there.
Prentice gives the free ball back. Opportunity for the Titans to go up 4-1. LeGrand with the swing, not down. Prentice. Got it!
Yeah.
Prentice pulls them back to within one. Morgan Sangle now back to serve. Junior defensive specialist. Good serve, gets in on the body of Valinch. Swing long, no touch, even at three.
Everybody talking to each other each time the play ends, both sides. A lot of communication, a lot of encouragement.
Sango's serve is long, and we've had three service errors here in this fifth set.
Is anybody hyped up here?
Yeah, right.
Or what?
We had 10 through basically four sets. But we've only been 7 points in, and we've already had three. And this touch, did they get the touch? No. Brandon wanted the touch, players wanted the touch. They're looking around, they heard it immediately. And now to serve is Harley Cole. Good pass. Prentice off the top of the block. Prentice keeps Gretna in it.
Talk about a grinder. She is coming in and she has just been phenomenal.
19 kills for Emma. But Damie slows, repositions. McCune off the block. Adami keeps it alive. Out of the back row. Hendricks not down. Back row the other way. Yost. LeGrand. Free ball. Good pass. Quick in the middle. Down. Emma O'Neill with the kill, and O'Neill has eight.
And she sliced that just right.
Kept it alive, down. Titans up by three.
O'Neill talking again, one at a time.
Out by Brandon, one of his two he has used here in the fifth. It has been back and forth. Titans take set number one. Gretna, set number two. Titans in the third, Gretna in the fourth. And want to remind you, an opportunity for you to pick up a DVD copy of these state high school championships. Football, volleyball, basketball, swimming and diving. Just call 800-868-1868 or log on to our website at netnebraska.org/sports. $19.95 plus shipping and handling, and you can relive these memories for a lifetime. And this is a good one. 7-4 Titans here in the fifth. Back to serve for the Titans, Ava LeGrand. McCune gets a run at it. Wide, no touch. Boy, McCune had a full swing on that one and just a bit wide, down by four. Chased it again. Back row with Yost.
Yost with a great up there.
It's down right in the back line. What a shot. 5-point advantage for the Titans. And the ace by LeGrand.
LeGrand has done it all in this match. Right now, big tough serve, pushing pressure at 10.
And now Mike Brandon forced to take his final timeout as the Titans have opened up a 6-point lead, and they're just 5 away from a state title. Brandon keeping it light in that huddle, big smiles, encouraging his team. This fifth set has been a run of 4 here for Papillion-La Vista South. They were even at 5-5, and it's been the 4-zip run that has extended it. Making a 5-zip run that's extended it to 10-5. 10-4. Overpass. Tip try, straight up. A Davey not down. Prentice found that back line. So now can they find some spark here in set number 5 as Prentice heads to the bench. Mackling comes in to serve. McCune, Anderson, Coleman across the front, and serve is wide. In to serve now for the Titans. Angelia Petrovic. And a serving error. Anderson now back to serve. Tough serve right along that sideline. And once again, Gretna Moore. She has made big swings when they have needed them the most. Not big numbers, but that's her 9th kill, hitting 280.
But she has delivered each time they've given her that opportunity.
McCune just long. And now the Titans are 2 away from a state title. And for the Dragons, Shayna Russell will play front row. Off the block and the kill by Yost. Or check that, McCune. And McCune now back to serve. They're going to have to go on a big run here to get back in it. As Titans just 2 away.
Again, Moore takes the opportunity. But you got to credit also, again, LeGrand running the system.
Championship point here in Class A. The Titans looking for the title. Block! LeGrand comes up big, and the Titans are title holders. It was an improbable run for the Papillion-La Vista South Titans, given where they were just 3 weeks ago. But the run that they went on late in the year and then through this state tournament, and in her first year, Katie Wright takes the Titans to a state championship in Class A. congratulations to the Papillion-La Vista South Titans. Let's take a look at championship point. Let's listen in. We'll get a trophy when we come back.
Early mornings, late nights, emotionally, physically, mentally tougher. Generations of trust, innovation, and hard work done side by side. The decisions you make for your land and livestock have a direct impact on your operation, the region, and the world. That is why we're there when you need us anytime, every time. We both have one chance, one season, one mission. Tougher together, Aurora and you.
The morning doesn't always start when you want it to. It starts when it has to. And day or night, we're up when you are. Through the good times, through the tough times. For the necessary and the unexpected. Even when you don't need us at all, we're just a light switch away. And when it's finally time to call it a night, we keep the lights on. Ready to do it all over again. Nebraska Public Power District, powering your every day, every day.
FFA's vision is to build leaders, grow communities, and strengthen agriculture.
The funds from Constellation will most likely be directed to one of those areas. But most importantly, people need to know that it is at the local level. It's helping local chapters.
Constellation provides natural gas for Nebraska homes, farms, ranches, and businesses. Through our support for 4-H and FFA, we're providing energy for Nebraska's future as well. Natural gas from Constellation.
Coverage of the 2019 NSAA Volleyball Championships on NET is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest, Nebraska Public Power District, Constellation, and Aurora Cooperative. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Well, our sixth and final state champion was crowned just moments ago, and what an exciting finish as Papillion-La Vista South, the Titans, take home the Class A championship. Now for medal and trophy presentations, down to Steve Lemon we go.
The Nebraska School Activities Association, the Nebraska Coaches Association, and the Nebraska Athletic Administrators Association are proud to support positive sportsmanship during the state championships and throughout the season. At this time, we are pleased to present the Sportsmanship Award for Class A. The trophy is graciously donated by Awards Unlimited. The sportsmanship program is exclusively presented by Concordia University of Nebraska, now proudly partnering with Concordia University Irvine, California, in offering the nation's number one graduate program in coaching and athletics administration and exercise sciences. Making the presentation from Concordia University is Scott Sievers, Senior Vice President for Enrollment and Marketing. The Class A Sportsmanship Award winner is Papillion-La Vista South High School. Congratulations, Papillion-La Vista South High School. The Nebraska School Activities Association is honored to have medals and trophies for both of these outstanding teams. Presentations will be made by NSAA Executive Director Jay Beller, NSAA Board of Director Dr. Bob Resnicek from Boystown, and U.S. Bank Representative Nick Powers. Here are the awards for runner-up Gretna High School. Head coach Mike Brandon and his assistants will present the silver medals. Players, please come forward as your name is called. Number three, Skylar McCoon. Number seven, Morgan Sengel. Number 12, Shayna Russell. Number 14, Savannah Shelburne. Number 19, Avery Coleman. Number 27, Josie Mason. Number 28, Emma Prentice. Number 36, Brooklyn Schuler. Number 38, Sydney Hoffman. And now the seniors. Number 2, Hannah Cathell. Number 6, Lydia Yost. Number 11, Avery Mackling. Number 13, Lauren Anderson. And number 55, Kennedy Schecker. For these outstanding athletes and their school, here's the 2019 NSAA Class A State Volleyball Runner-Up Trophy. Congratulations, Gretna High School. Champions, Papillion-La Vista South High School. Head coach Katie Wright, we have a special award for you. Coach Wright and her assistants will present the gold medals. Players, please come forward as your name is called. Number 2, Delaney Valinch. Number 3, Brecken Moore. Number 4, Aaliyah Clark. Number 5, Harley Cole. Number 7, Stella Adeyemi. Number 8, Angelia Petrovic. Number 9, Kinley Siss. Number 10, Emma O'Neill. Number 11, Ava LeGrand. Number 12, Margaret Madden. Number 14, Shaylee Weavers. And now the seniors. Number 1, Ashlyn Dirks. Number 6, Dayton Valinch. And number 13, Sophie Hendricks. Presenting the championship game ball from Farmers Mutual Insurance, Senior Vice President, Investments and Real Estate, Tim Schlesselmilk. And now for these outstanding athletes and their school, here is the 2019 NSAA Class A State Volleyball Championship Trophy. Congratulations, Papillion-La Vista South High School.
They're the state champs from Papillion-La Vista South. The Titans are on top for the fourth time in program history. And when we come back, we will hear from those champions, including first-year head coach Stay with us.
Not just on the good days. Not just on the challenging ones. Not just during business hours. Or when relaxing. But always. For the past 125 years, Farmers Mutual of Nebraska, always alongside you.
Wow, what is this?
This is a template on many different kinds of infusions.
I like where you're going with this.
And can I taste it?
Sure, go ahead.
I can smell it all the way over here. Yeah, that's... It was immediate.
This is delicious. Yeah.
Looking at their history, we can understand that maybe they have a point.
There's your template.
We good to go?
Well, I want to clean up a little bit, and then we'll go outside.
Is for
communities, which help kids grow smarter, stronger, and kinder. And we have resources for the challenges and joys families experience. It's all on Sesame Street in communities.org, where you'll find activities and videos for kids and grown-ups.
C is for community and cookie. Om, nom, nom, nom,
oh, oh, oh. Join us at Sesame Street in communities.org.
Make Wednesday night on PBS your destination for exploration. Beginning with nature.
The planet's biggest beasts capture our imagination like no other.
Followed by Nova.
We are really able to get inside the painting.
And life from above.
This is our home as we've never seen it before.
Nature, Nova, and life from above. Starting at 8, 7 Central, only on PBS.
Of the 2019 NSAA Volleyball Championships on NET is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest, Nebraska Public Power District, Constellation, and Aurora Cooperative. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. The trophy on the floor, and they also won the sportsmanship trophy as the student body came pouring out of the stands to help this volleyball team celebrate a state championship. And now we get to hear from the state champs, and for that, let's go to Ryan Mix.
Thank you, Larry. Yeah, here with Katie Ryan. And Katie, what a thrilling match. Five setter and just back and forth, about a 2-hour match, because it seemed like neither team could get the ball down on the first hit. Have you taken time to collect your breath and your thoughts, and how are you feeling right now?
Oh, I feel amazing. These girls are just special. They're really special. They've proven that over the course of the season, that they are not willing to lay down and die, especially in this last 2 months of the season. They've shown so much heart, so much grit. They have fought, and they weren't gonna. I just knew they were not gonna let this go.
Entering the state tournament, you guys were the 7th seed, had 17 losses this year, and I'm sure quite a few teams might have, you know, wrote you guys off. But for you guys to win 3 games here at state, how happy are you with this group?
Like I said, I'm just amazed at them. I am in awe of them. But it's more about who they are as people. Like, they have shown time and time again that they are gritty and they're going to fight for everything and they're going to take care of each other. And that's what they've done. They've shown that.
Okay, I've been told that we want you to look at the monitor right now. Okay. And this is your reaction to winning a state championship. You got to love it. When was the last time you've had a reaction like that?
I don't know. Well, I feel like I react like that every time they get a block or a kill. I'm probably a little more subdued, but they just make me so happy. They play for each other, and it's so fun to watch. It's so fun to watch.
Well, Coach, congratulations. Obviously, a heck of a run by your team.
Thank you very much.
All right, let's bring in Ava LeGrand. Ava had 21 kills to lead the Titans, 20 assists. 16 digs, he did it all. And how are you feeling now that you're a state champ?
I'm so proud of everyone on the team. It feels amazing.
This team obviously has gone through a lot. You guys were 15 and 16 at this time a month ago.
Really?
And now you're state champs. Did you think, you know, at that point a month ago that this could be possible right now?
I think it was possible. I think we knew from the beginning of the season it was possible. We just had to put our mind to it, and everyone had to be in it, like, full on. And we did that, yeah.
Class A field this year was, you know, just really good. Obviously, Papillion-La Vista ranks nationally in the top 10. Millard North, obviously, had a difficult situation forfeiting those wins, but the defending champs, and you guys are the last ones standing. So for everyone that wrote you guys off, what's your message to them tonight?
Don't underestimate the underdog, I guess. I don't know. Just, yeah, play till the ball drops. I don't know.
What did you think was ultimately the difference for you guys to come out on top tonight?
I don't know. We had nothing to lose. We were the seventh seed. No one really thought we were going to win. And we knew in our hearts that everyone knew that we could do this.
Congratulations, Ava.
Thank you.
All right, let's bring in Sophie Hendricks. The senior had 13 kills, 19 digs. Do you feel like echoing her thoughts that you guys just came in here with a fearless mentality?
I really think we did. We came from, like you said, seventh seed, and it's hard. It's hard to come in and fight these big teams like Elkhorn South. We definitely didn't think that was going to be a sweep, but we got it done, and we pushed through, and we definitely deserved this.
Coach is very big on mental toughness. She told me that you guys spent almost an entire practice going through mental drills as opposed to volleyball drills. What was that like, and how did you guys respond after that?
It was definitely frustrating at times, but I think that it really brought our team together. And being a senior on the court, I love seeing the underclassmen improve from day one. And it just makes me so happy seeing us like improve that much.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Papillion-La Vista South, they start the year 3-6. They were swept 8 times this year, and here they are, state champions. Larry, let's toss it back to you.
Well, thank you very much, Ryan. I guess that's why they say that's why they play the game, right? To take you all the way back to, do you remember this, Kathy? This was 9 a.m. this morning.
Oh.
We were sitting up here watching the D2 title game, and the D2 title game between BDS and St. Francis went 5 sets. Macy Kamler was outstanding. She had 30 kills, and BDS wins back-to-back state championship 16-14 in set number 5. And then a first ever for us, Diller Odell. They were impressive throughout the tournament as they swept their way to the state title.
Absolutely came out, and again, that fearless is a word we've used this day. And I guess they came out, they're aggressive, stepped out on the court and took charge right from the beginning.
And there is a first ever title for Diller Odell. And then we go to Class C2, where we had the Legends game. This is Sharon Savala, Adam Vancura coaching against each other. Both coaches, 40-plus years. Grand Island Central Catholic had won 9 state titles in program history. They pick up number 10 today, 3-0.
You know, and both these teams, as we mentioned, outstanding. But again, fight to the end. GICC comes out on top.
Had a terrific showdown. St. Paul came in unbeaten on the year. Lincoln Lutheran was the number 2 seed, and Lincoln Lutheran takes home its first title since 2004. They win it 3-1, and boy, Bus was special in this one.
She definitely was incredible out there on the court. Really, what a dynamic player, and led this team, took them on their backs, and again, collectively, 15 years ago, now state champions again.
Then we move to Class B, where Omaha Scott just continues to roll. They came in as the 4-time defending state champions, and they make it 5 in a row.
And they played so clean, so complete, and again, so many weapons out there. Just tough matchup, and again, they just come from left, right, every direction. And again, on a roll, five in a row.
And the one you just finished watching?
Who was that again?
That's right.
Yeah, no.
Papillion-La Vista South with the win.
Wow, what a match. I mean, we talked about it from the beginning. Gritty, grinding match. And again, both teams were not going to let this go. And in that final fifth set match, really Papillion kind of flexed their muscle at the last moment and comes out on top with a big win and state championship to their name. First time for Coach Wright.
We bookend it with five setters. We started this morning with a five setter. We finished with a five setter. Papillion-La Vista South wins it 3-2. We just wrapped up a 13-hour day right there in about a minute and a half. But here are your champs: BDS, Diller O'Dell, GICC, Lincoln Lutheran, Scutt Catholic, and Papillion-La Vista South. I think a couple of things will stick with me, and I'd like your thoughts as well. First of all, the level of talent just doesn't change in this state. We're in a state of 1.8 million, and the level of talent that we have here in Nebraska truly is remarkable. So many Knicks level players, but then also notice today the number of young players that number of freshmen who had big contributions to their team throughout the year, and volleyball is going to be pretty solid here for quite a while in the state.
I think we're in pretty good hands here with the teams. Again, like you said, outstanding play today. I mean, how many state tournaments across the nation looked like we had in front of us here today? And again, incredible play, all classes, all levels. And also, I want to talk about the coaches. We've got veterans. We've got young folks, again, doing great things, doing things that, again, make our state great. And those young players are training. They're getting that good quality training, not only physical training, their strategic, their mental training, their team components. They're doing it all. It's pretty impressive.
It was a showcase day. Showcase day for Nebraska volleyball, level of talent, and also the level of coaching that we have as well. So, Kathy, terrific job. Great to be with you again this year to do these state championships. Hey, I want to thank everybody at home for joining us. It was our pleasure to bring you these state high school championships across the entire state of Nebraska. You were able to witness some of the top talent in the state take home six championship trophies throughout the day. So one final time for our outstanding NET production crew, for Kathy Wieskamp, for Ryan Mix, I'm Larry Putney. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you next time right back here on your home for sports, NET Sports.
I'm Nicole Brungart, and I'm a part of the U.S. Women's Bobsled team. I'm a four-time All-American, and I'm from Norfolk, Nebraska. Bobsledding was definitely not in the picture when I was growing up, but I'm thankful to be where I'm at, and I'll never take that for granted. In my career, I'm getting bumped around, bruised in the back of the bobsled, so it's super important that I keep up with my sleep, my nutrition, seeing my trainer, seeing the chiropractor, and staying in the gym so I can be at the top of my game when competition comes.